Doctor Who. Unlucky 13 Part 2 by David T. Lomax. The Cybermen fight. Going back to the day the Doctor was kidnapped, the Doctor and Clara unit are trying to stop the Cybermen. They are fighting to stop what they think is Missy slash Master. Back at where the Cybermen were attacking unit outside of St. Paul's Cathedral, unit shoot them down with gold bullets as they know it works to stop and kill them. Kate Stewart, who gave them the order to shoot down the Cybermen that came down the stairs. What is regeneration? Clara, Doctor, how are we going to stop the Cybermen? The Doctor, I am not sure. We have to stop Missy. Unit will sort out the rest of the Cybermen, but somehow, I have to get in there somehow. Clara, who is Missy? Why does she seem to be going after you? The Doctor, she says she Missy, meaning she is the Master, but I don't believe that. I think she is someone else. But one thing I like to know, who is the lady in the shop who give you my number? Clara, the lady in the shop, the one said that this is the number that will help me with my internet provider.
Listen, where did you get this number?
The woman in the shop wrote it down.
It's a helpline, isn't it? She said it's the best helpline out there in the universe, she said.
What woman? Who was she?
I don't know. The woman in the shop. So...
why isn't there internet? Shouldn't it just sort of...
The Doctor, yeah. Yes, but what did she look like? Clara, she was blonde, brown eyes, why ask? The Doctor, no matter, we will find out soon, but I love good mystery. Clara, so, how are we going into St. Paul's Cathedral without the Cybermen seeing us? The Doctor, well, if Unit could somehow distract the two Cybermen at the doors, then I am in the building, where this Missy person is, whoever she is, like I believe she the Master as if. Clara, why don't you believe she the Master? The Doctor, because Gallifreyans are a humanoid species, and one thing we can't do is change gender. It's like a process of healing. Clara looks confused. Look at this way, when a human heals from, say, broken leg or just a small cut, your body heals itself. You don't change gender in that healing process, right? Clara, right. The Doctor, that how regeneration is like. It's a healing process. Regeneration adapts to our chromosomes we are born as, like I was born as male. The only thing that is different, we have antibodies like any other humanoid does have. When we are close to death or dying, that is when a regeneration cycle takes over. Clara, what about female Time Lords, or should I say Time Ladies? The Doctor, yes, the same thing applies to the females. Our gender stays the same, even though we can heal our bodies and renew them through regeneration cycles. It's like cheating death, but not really. Do you understand now? Clara, yes, but if that's the case, like you say, then who is this Missy then? If she not really the Master, like you said, then who is she then? The mystery of the Doctor of Missy. The Doctor, that is the mystery that I am going to find out. Clara, I am coming with you. The Doctor, no, no, you're not, you're staying here. I can't have anything happen to you. You can stay here with Kate Stewart, I'm sure she will look after you, would you, Kate? Kate Stewart, yes, I will, Doctor. Clara, but Doctor. The Doctor, now Clara, I want you to stay with Kate. It'd be far safer for you to be with her, and I won't want anything to happen to you. Kate Stewart, so, Doctor, what's the plan? We can't get our weapons to get close enough to get the two Cybermen at the doors. We can't get too close, they just shoot at us, and before we even shoot back, they already taken out some of my team. How we going to get them up the stairs without them seeing us? Our team taken me out, the Cybermen that came down the stairs out. But how do we take the two of the Cybermen at the doors? The Doctor, well, if we somehow go in from the sides without them seeing us, see if they have a blind spot where they can't see us. Kate Stewart, okay, I can get two of my men to come in from the sides to take the Cybermen down, and then you're in the doors. If it works, do you want them coming with you? The Doctor tries to speak, Kate Stewart butts back in, but if they do see you, we could actually blind them with full high beam light. That way we do have a distraction. I am sorry you were going to say something, Doctor. The doctor, yes, I was going to say I will pick who goes with me, is that okay? Kate Stewart, okay, that's fine. What you going to do, Doctor? The doctor, I got a plan, but I pick them too. The doctor pick out of the unit team one man and a woman. Kate Stewart, before you go, doctor, take these radios with you, so you can radio into us what is going on, but try to be quiet so the Cybermen don't hear you. The doctor, I am sure we will be quiet as mice. As the doctor heads off with Kate Stewart unit officers, he takes the two of them, a woman, the other a man that the doctor picked. The doctor asks them their names. The woman, his name is Jane, and the man is named Alex King, who is muscular and is white but smart too. Jane is can be too smart for her own good and thinks there is plan B to everything. She sometimes doesn't like being told what to do. She likes to take things in her own hands. The doctor tells Alex come in the side from the right and Jane come in from left side. Make sure the Cybermen don't see you, but if they do, Kate Stewart will blind them with full high beam light that if something goes wrong and they see us. Clara, you think they going to be okay? Kate Stewart, I am sure they going to be fine, the doctor has a plan. Clara, yes, and that worries me. Kate Stewart, don't worry too much. The plan of action. The doctor, now remember what I said to do. Alex, you're with me. Jane, you have to go in from the left, on your own, and I give you signal when it's come in at the left sides to take left Cyberman out. We will come in from the right side to take the one on the right out, so let's do this. Jane, wait, doctor, before we go, what is the signal? The doctor, oh yeah, the signal I give little flicker from my sonic screwdriver, but it be like this. The doctor shows the three low light flickers from his sonic screwdriver to Jane will be like. Alex King and the doctor head of two right ready to take out the Cybermen from the right side of St. Paul's Cathedral at the front the main doors, whereas Jane heads of in the left direction. They get set for the plan set out for them by the doctor. Alex King, I hope this works out. The doctor, sure, hope so, now let's do this, just hope Jane remembers the signal. Alex King, I am sure she does, but was it me or did it seem like she wasn't listening to you? The doctor, you really think so? I thought she was, it felt like she was. The doctor radios into Kate that they are in position. The doctor, okay Kate, we are in position. Kate Stewart, radios back to the doctor, okay doctor? Cybermen in death. Alex King, doctor, I can see Jane, she about to, wait, what she doing, she going to give us away? Kate Stewart radios in on Jane and asks but whispers in the radio. Kate Stewart, radios to Jane, what you trying to do, Jane? Jane, radios back at Kate in whispered voice, I know what I am doing, if I could somehow get up to them without them seeing me. I can shoot them both down. Kate Stewart, radios back at Jane in a mad whispered voice, you better stick to the doctor's plan. Jane, radios back to Kate, I can take them down myself. Kate Stewart, just do as you are told. Cybermen hears Jane on the radio. One of the Cybermen walks in her direction and shoots at Jane. She tries to shoot back, but she gets shoot down herself by the Cybermen. Alex T, OMG, they just shoot Jane down. Doctor, how could they hurt Jane from all the way from there? The doctor, I am not sure, unless they could pick up the radio signal the closer she went to them. The little life that Jane had left, she takes out the left Cyberman with the gold bullets that she had left. Then Alex King takes his chance and takes of the one on the right, as that one has moved on to the left side, take other shoot at Jane, and that when Alex King takes out that one remaining Cyberman. Alex King, well, at least some part of your plans worked, doctor, it's shame about Jane though. The doctor, yes, but that's what happens when you don't listen to me. I may as well get a tattoo on my head that says, oh, I am the doctor, don't listen to me. The doctor kicks the dead Cyberman, ow. My foot. Alex King, you all right, doctor? The doctor, yes, but one these days someone is going to listen to me. Alex King, what you going to do now? The doctor, I guess I have to go in there now. Alex King, you need a hand? The doctor, no, not at all, I don't want another death on my hands. Alex King, you sure as you seem to be limping? The doctor, yes, I am fine, my foot and myself will be fine, Alex, I am sure you will listen to me and stay out here, you got that?
Alex King, yes, doctor, you have my word, but if I hear something wrong, I am going in there, and I will go in there to help you, as backup.
The doctor, okay, that's fair. The doctor in St. Paul's Cathedral. The doctor heads in St. Paul's Cathedral at the main doors. The doctor walks down the corridors of St. Paul's Cathedral. The doctor, this place should be crawling with Cybermen. The doctor continues on and looks through the corridors of St. Paul's Cathedral and walks into a room that is very creepy and looks like an experiment room. The doctor notices a Cyberman head on the table. The doctor thinks out loud and says to himself, I have a creepy feeling about all this. The doctor walks through the doors. In that room, there are tanks with four skeletons in them. The doctor, now then, why would they be the only ones still in the tanks? I know you are Cyberman, why not come out and play? Missy slash Madame Kovarian walks in the room. They are not just Cybermen, doctor. The doctor looks around to see Missy slash Madame Kovarian stood there. Doctorin in the Matrix. The doctor, then what are they, if not just Cybermen? Missy slash Madame Kovarian, well, it's all about you, isn't it, and how you started, isn't it? The doctor, who are you really? Missy slash Madame Kovarian, I think you already know that. The doctor, what the I am, the master, nice try, time lords and time ladies can't change gender, regeneration is like. It's a healing process, regeneration adapts to our chromosomes we are born as, every time lord and time lady knows this. So, I ask again, who are you? Missy slash Madame Kovarian, oh, alright, you got me, I am some you know before and met once before. The doctor, then tell me. Missy slash Madame Kovarian, okay doctor, keep your hair on, so we humans say. Madame Kovarian reveals herself by switching of the biomodicator off, so she no longer in the Missy form, but just Madame Kovarian. The shock on the doctor's face to find out that behind all this is Madame Kovarian. The doctor intensely knows this is a trap for him. The doctor tries to get out, but his sonic screwdrivers doesn't work on a deadlock seal. Madame Kovarian, where do you think you're going now, doctor? Your sonic screwdriver isn't going to work on a deadlock seal, so might as well give up now, you want to meet my friends. As the skeletons in the tank stand up, the water drains and reveals and Mondasian Cybermen. Mondasian Cybermen and the doctor. The doctor, sad face, shocked tone in a voice, Mondasian Cybermen, but how? Madame Kovarian, oh, you'll love to know that, wouldn't you? Besides, it was fun experimenting on the dead, just to trap you was good. The doctor, experimenting on the dead, how can you do that? It's imposible. Well, almost, where did you get the knowledge to do that? Madame Kovarian, that is for me to know, and you to find out. Cyber slash Bill restrain the doctor. Cyber Bill restrains the doctor down on his knees. Cybermen don't have names. The doctor, what you going to do to me, and since when do Cybermen have names? Madame Kovarian, it is who they used to be, before they got converted, why should I explain these things to you? The doctor, if this all a trap for me, maybe you should tell me? Madame Kovarian, well, you know the master, doctor? The doctor, you are working for the master? Madame Kovarian, no, but nice try and really good guess. I got him all locked up in a matrix pod. The doctor, Madame Kovarian, how did you get the master in some matrix pod? Madame Kovarian, I kidnapped him, I thought you all people would have worked that out. The doctor, okay then, how did you kidnap the master then? You couldn't have done that one on your own, so who else is behind all this? Madame Kovarian, you mean who I am working for other than the Cybermen, you love to know that, wouldn't you? The doctor, yes, that why I asked the question in the first place, so you going to answer that then? Madame Kovarian, let's say she doesn't like you. The doctor, that doesn't tell me much. Madame Kovarian, think about it, doctor, the one time lord, or should I say time lady, that really doesn't like you. The doctor, the Ronnie, I should have known. She is the mastermind behind all this. No pun intended to the master, of course. Madame Kovarian, oh, he can't hear you in there. The doctor, how did you meet the Ronnie then? Madame Kovarian, when I met the Ronnie just after Demon's Run, we got taking, and she and I had a lot in common. The doctor, what is that, you're both nuts.
Madam Kovarian, no doctor that we both hate you, I wanted to bring you down. I told her I want to get my revenge on the man called the doctor. She was very interested, so instead of me killing you I wanted to mess with you good plus I wanted the key of time and change it and get rid of you for sure, this time, I will win this war. So, she told me everything I needed to know.
The doctor, and where is the Ronnie?
Madam Kovarian, who knows, but she did tell me how to experiment on the dead hence Cybermen.
The doctor, what about the Mondasian Cybermen?
Madam Kovarian, no, they are not dead, or though they might as well be now.
The doctor, you're such a...
Madam Kovarian, oh, language doctor.
Madam Kovarian brings out the matrix pods for the doctor. Madam Kovarian beams out the matrix pod that had the master in onto the cybership.
The doctor, what is that empty pod for?
Madam Kovarian, it's for you of course, who else would it be for?
Cyber Bill bring the doctor to the pod and forces the doctor in the matrix pod.
The doctor is in the matrix.
The doctor, I guessing that the Ronnie told how to make the matrix pods?
Madam Kovarian, what do you think?
The doctor, I am taking that as a yes?
Madam Kovarian switches on the matrix pod the doctor is in. The doctor starts to fall asleep into matrix.
Madam Kovarian gathers the Mondasian Cybermen and beams up into a spaceship. From outside of St. Paul's Cathedral you could see this flash of light from the beam itself.
Meanwhile outside St. Paul's Cathedral.
Clara, something is wrong, something doesn't seem right.
Kate Stewart radios the doctor.
Kate Stewart, doctor, you there?
No answer from the doctor.
Clara, I am going in there.
Clara runs off to help the doctor, but she doesn't know it's too late.
Kate Stewart, no.
Clara, come back.
Alex King tries to stop Clara, but she runs away. She gets away from Alex King.
Clara enters the building of St. Paul's Cathedral.
The Cyberman disappears.
Kate Stewart speaks into the radio.
What was that flash of light just now?
A unit officer radios in from the other side of the building of St. Paul's Cathedral and says, what is going on? Where did the Cybermen go?
Kate Stewart radios back, what you mean where did they go?
The unit officer radio in back to Kate Stewart and says, the Cybermen, they just disappeared, mom, just the one that are dead left.
Kate Stewart radio backs to the unit officer, send some our officers in there and find the doctor, and Clara has gone in there too. Alex did try to stop her, but she got away.
Unit officer, okay team, we need to get in there.
The unit team reply back, yes sir, Alex, you get in there to find Clara.
The unit team head in St. Paul's Cathedral and find there is no sign of the doctor.
They all can hear Clara shouting out for the doctor, but don't see her, then everything went silence.
Looking for the doctor.
Alex King, Clara, doctor.
Alex walks in the room where all the cyber tanks were. Alex King finds the doctor's radio on the floor. Alex radios to Kate Stewart, I found the doctor's radio but no sign of him anywhere. I heard Clara for a moment, but I have not seen her. It's like she just disappeared. Did the doctor head back to the TARDIS?
Kate Stewart, the TARDIS, where is the TARDIS?
You think he is in the TARDIS?
Alex King, I don't know, we can't find Clara, mom, you okay?
Kate Stewart, everyone out of St. Paul's now.
Something is wrong, we need to find the TARDIS and the doctor quick.
The unit officer and Alex King finds the TARDIS. It is at the back of St. Paul's Cathedral.
No sign of Clara in the building.
Alex King sees Clara come outside, from the side of the building. She runs up to the TARDIS shouting, doctor.
The TARDIS starts taking off. Clara grabs the front of the doors and the TARDIS takes off, with her holding on to the outside of doors of the TARDIS. The TARDIS leaves with Clara holding on the doors.
There is wall behind where the TARDIS was. It says two words, bad wolf.
The TARDIS tries to home in onto the doctor, in way to find him with Clara holding on the doors and the time vortex.
TARDIS lands on the ship where the Cybermen are on.
Clara drops down and gets found by the Cybermen. But Madame Kovarian stops them from trying to kill her. She comes up with idea. She puts Clara in the matrix pod on another floor away for where the doctor is.
6 years later and no sign of the doctor.
The TARDIS lands in Unit HQ basement. Alex King heads to where Kate Stewart's office is at. He knocks on her door.
Missing doctor and the TARDIS.
Kate Stewart, ah? Alex, yes, come in. Alex King, Mom, the TARDIS just landed in our basement. Kate Stewart, any sign of the doctor? Alex King, no Mom, I don't think so. Kate Stewart, okay Alex, I see you later while I make a phone call. To make sense with the part 1 where Kate Stewart and Captain Jack are in the TARDIS. Meanwhile back inside of the TARDIS with Kate Stewart and Captain Jack. Kate Stewart, the TARDIS, can it translate Gallifreyan? Captain Jack, yes, but I wish I knew how to turn it on somehow. Captain Jack finds and presses the translator button on, it says help the doctor, he needs help, he is in trouble. Kate Stewart finds Alex King and teams up with some of the officers to step into the TARDIS to save the doctor. Alex King and a few unit team members chosen by Kate Stewart to join her, and Captain Jack in the TARDIS. The TARDIS accepted the help and takes off with them and lands on the ship of the Cybermen. TARDIS on the Cybermen ship. Captain Jack, are we landed? Alex King, so, what do we do now? Captain Jack, I can see what is out there on the TARDIS scanner. Captain Jack turns on the TV scanners to see what is out there. Kate Stewart, looks like the TARDIS landed us in a corridor. I wonder where the doctor is held. Alex King, how are we going to stop all them Cybermen? Can the TARDIS scanner look for way to find the doctor? Captain Jack, I don't think so, but you can see them Cybermen at the doors. They are guarding something on that side of the corridor, and I bet that where the doctor is. Kate Stewart, I hope you're right about this. Alex King, I hope we got enough teammates and gold bullets to take them down. Just one question, can they see us? I mean the TARDIS. Captain Jack, no, I think TARDIS can make herself unseeing by cloaking herself. Kate Stewart, well okay, let's get going. I don't think the doctor is going to save himself. Alex King and his unit teammates get ready to take the Cybermen guards at the onside of the corridor. They shoot them down at both sides. Alex King, that was way too easy. They all walk through the doors and find themselves in pod room full of Cybermen. Kate Stewart, I thought you said this is way to the doctor? Captain Jack, I did, that's what the vortex manipulator scanner says. Kate Stewart, you have vortex manipulator, but how? Captain Jack, I made it at the new Torchwood, its prototype, I being working on. I will program it to locate the doctor. Cybermen and Matrix pod room. So, the team follow Captain Jack and notices the Cybermen in the first pods in that row. Captain Jack, oh my god, we are in Cybermen pod room. Alex King, you sure? They don't look the Cybermen we taken out at St. Paul's Cathedral. Captain Jack, yes, what else they could be, why ask? Alex King, they look so different. Kate Stewart, Alex is right, they don't look like the ones we encountered before. Although they do look like the ones my father fought when unit was in his command, but these ones look so different to ones as my dad described to me. The Cybermen attack. Madam Kovarian, over the ship's tannoid speakers, if you're here to save the doctor you have to get past them first. Alex King, who is that? Madam Kovarian, just old friend of the doctor's, or is its old enemy, I forget which. Alex King, looking into a matrix pod, I never seeing this kind of Cybermen before? Madam Kovarian, they are the first Cybermen the doctor ever faced, they are Mondasian Cybermen. Can you stop them? I bet you can't get past them. Madam Kovarian wakens the Mondasian Cybermen, the unit team and captain see them waking up, moving out of the pod slowly. Emotions, love, pride, fear. Captain Jack, everyone move back now. Every one of the unit team and Captain Jack run back where they come from. Madam Kovarian locks the door they come into from. Mondasian Cybermen are saying you cannot resist us, you will become like us repeatedly, as they walk up slowly to the team of unit. Mondasian Cybermen saying we will remove emotions and fear. Alex King, oh my god, this it, we are dead. Unit team mates try to shoot at the Cybermen. Madam Kovarian, did I forget to tell you that gold bullets are not going to work on Mondasian Cybermen? It did slip my mind, oh dear, laughs. Mondasian Cybermen kill 3 teammates of unit, out of 6 Alex King's team. They tried to defend the team from the Mondasian Cybermen. Captain Jack asks the rest of the team to hold on while he pins the doctor down with his vortex manipulator, by using a vortex jump to where the doctor is. However, this doesn't work right away. The other three unit team mates try to keep back the Mondasian Cybermen. They get killed part from one called Elizabeth Snowden. Captain Jack, everyone grab onto me quickly. Alex King, hurry up Jack, they starting to get faster. Captain Jack, I'm going fast as I can. The Mondasian Cybermen almost getting to them closer. Kate Stewart, oh my god, this is it. Elizabeth Snowden shoots at them, the Mondasian Cybermen, just about the reach to her and the team, she screams.